Please read 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verses 19 and 20.
Or do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit within you, which you have from God, and that you are not your own? For you were bought with a price, therefore glorify God in your body.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
My dear friends, you are the temple of the Holy Spirit. Who are you?
Temple of the Holy
you
Spirit.
You are the temple of the Holy Spirit. So glorify God in your body. The way you think, the way you dress, the way you walk about, the way you talk, the way you dance, the way you sing, in all what you do, you should glorify God. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Why? Your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. Now, 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verses 9 and 10, please read.
Do you not know that wrongdoers will not inherit the kingdom of God? Do not be deceived. Fornicators, idolaters, adulterers, male prostitutes, sodomites, thieves, the greedy, drunkards, revilers, robbers, none of these will inherit the kingdom of God.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Now, my dear friends, the list is before you. Check yourself and see, where are you? Where are you? Check and see. If you have sinned, repent and come back to God. Never say, I have no sin. If you say you have no sin, you deceive yourselves and the truth is not in you. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Repent. Come back to God right now. Confess your sins. Ask the Lord to forgive your sins. Our Lord Jesus Christ will forgive all your sins and give you a new life. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Remember, the body is meant not for fornication, but for the Lord. The body is meant not for fornication, but for the Lord. The Lord for the body. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Matthew chapter 5, verse 28, Jesus says that everyone who looks at a woman with lust has already committed adultery with her in his heart. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Enough if you look at a woman. Enough you look at a man with lust in your eye. You have already committed adultery with her or with him in your heart. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So my dear friends, see that you have a control over your eyes. If your eye is causing you to sin, tear it off and throw it away. If your hand is causing you to sin, cut it off and throw it away. If your right leg is causing you to sin, cut it off and throw it away. Jesus says, it is better for a person to go into heaven with one eye, one hand, and one leg, rather than going into hell with two eyes, two hands, and two legs. What do you prefer?
To go to heaven.
Go to heaven. Check and see. Sin no more. Sin no more. Be holy because you are the temple of the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Now King David, the great man, have failed to keep control over his eyes. He committed adultery with Uriah's wife. She became pregnant. To hide this matter, he killed Uriah in the battle and took his wife to be his wife. Okay? Our Lord God could not tolerate this. He did not spare David just because he was anointed king, man after his heart. But he sent Nathan. Nathan went and said, David, you have sinned. He has exposed his secret sins. David was heartbroken. He cried, he wept, he prayed, Lord, do not cast me away from your presence. Do not take away the Holy Spirit from me. He wept for his sins. He cried for his sins. He asked for mercy. Our Lord God was so merciful towards him. He forgave all his sins and gave him a new life. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
My dear friends, now listen. Whoever you may be, you may be a great or a low or educated, not educated, you may be. If you have committed sin against God and man, right now ask pardon. Ask the Lord, Lord, I have sinned. I have gone astray. Forgive my sins, Lord. Ask him. He will forgive all your sins and give you a new life. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.